Good morning, this is Kasturi Day. Today I'll discuss the evaporation, start with the evaporation which produces cooling effect, okay, and other applications of evaporation, okay. So this is the chapter, matter chapter according to ICSE syllabus class 8. So I'll start with, so first we come to evaporation which produces cooling, okay. When a little alcohol or spirit is poured on the palm, if we see that when we pour some liquid alcohol or spirit, especially when we apply nail polish, no, in our fingers, we can see that our nails feel cool. So why is it so? Because it contains spirit. And why this spirit gives us cooling? Because it on cooling, it gives a soothing effect, okay. So this is due to evaporation. It happens because in some alcohol, if some alcohol spirit is poured on cotton or wool which is wrapped around a ball or a thermometer, the reading of the thermometer falls, okay. So if, for example, it shows the cooling is this example shows that the cooling is produced when a liquid evaporates. So this is this cooling effect on our nails due to this evaporation. The cooling effect which we find it on our nails when we apply nail polish, or when we wrap cotton which is dipped in alcohol or spirit, and this is wrapped around a thermometer bulb, the thermometer reading falls. This is all due to the evaporation which produces a cooling effect, because when a liquid changes into vapor, it requires heat which is supplied from the surroundings of the liquid, okay. So when the liquid it changes into vapor, we know that there is a gain in the kinetic energy of the molecules of the liquid, which is due to the heat which is which the molecules get it from the surroundings, okay. So in this case, from the palm or cotton, okay, or from the nails around the skin, around the nails, okay. So this is the heat is supplied from those regions which evaporates the spirit or alcohol, okay, and this produces a cooling effect, and the thermometer reading also falls, okay. So this is the main reason behind it. Next we come to the applications of evaporation. I told you we will discuss some other applications also. So in summer, water gets cooled in an earthen pot, okay. You have seen many especially in Indian houses, in the earlier days we used to keep when there was no refrigerator, we used to keep water in the earthen pots to keep to make the water cool during the summer season, because water seeps out from on the surface of these earthen pots through the pores of the pot, and it evaporates. This heat, the heat required for the evaporation, is taken from the water inside, which is inside the pot, okay, and hence it gets cooled, which evaporates the water from the which has come out from the pores, and this produces a cooling effect. Now doctors, they advise us when we fall sick, any of us have fever, and high fever rather, so doctor advises to put some wet cloth on the forehead, piece of cloth on the forehead, because water of the strip of the cloth which has been put on the forehead, that water absorbs the heat from the body, okay, and it evaporates, okay, and thus that reduces the temperature of the body, that reduces the temperature of the head and rather from the body, okay. So the fever comes down. Then again, we often pour ice in we often pour tea in a saucer to cool it fast. Why? Because this saucer, when we pour a tea in a cup, that area, the surface area of the cup is smaller than the compared to that of the saucer. So when we want to cool the tea which is poured into the cup, we pour it into the saucer. So we get a more surface area where the air can blow, and this can produce evaporation. This can instigate evaporation to carry on, and what happens that evaporation is faster in the large surface area. Okay, so that can cool down the tea more fast than in a cup. And then evaporation of sweat from a body helps to maintain the body temperature at 37 degrees centigrade or 98 degrees Fahrenheit. Because what happens, the sweat while evaporating takes away the body heat. Okay, and this reduces the temperature of the body and keep it at a optimum temperature, that is 37 degrees centigrade or 38 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, what is the one question is there, I'll ask you, you please reply in the comment box. Okay, what is the basic difference between a gas and a vapor? Okay, I'll tell you in my next video about this answer, discuss in the next video. Now, next we come to the change of solid into gas or vice versa. Okay, when a solid changes into vapor, directly into vapor without melting, or gas rather, vapor or gaseous state on heating without changing into liquid at a fixed temperature, that is known as sublimation. Okay. When the gas is cooled, it directly again changes into solid without becoming liquid, then that is known as deposition. Okay, for example, these type of solids are ammonium chloride, iodine, camphor, naphthalene, and solid carbon dioxide, that is we call dry ice. When heated, they changes directly into vapor. When these vapors are cooled, they change into their solids. Noted, the fixed temperature at which change of the state occurs, a quantity of heat is given to or taken from the substance. Okay, when this change of state takes place, so what happens, a quantity of heat is either given out or taken in to convert the state. Okay, but this heat does not change its temperature, there is no rise or fall in temperature. Okay, this heat is the latent heat or hidden heat which gets stored in the substance, which is used to overcome the kinetic and to overcome the to work against this a force of attraction. Okay, when the kinetic energy becomes more, this heat is gained by the molecules to and the kinetic energy increases to overcome the force of attraction, is becomes more than the force of attraction, and what happens, the substance changes to liquid or gas. Okay, because the molecules move more faster than the solids. Okay, and again reverse takes place when the heat is given out, that is kinetic energy comes down, reduces than the force of attraction, that is force of attraction becomes more and kinetic energy becomes less, and the molecules, they movement, their intermolecular spaces reduces, and the substance either changes into from gas to liquid or liquid to solid, or rather from solid to directly to gas and gas to solid. So change of state takes place in this way, and this heat which is used to overcome these changes, to carry on these changes, that is known as latent heat, that does not change the temperature, that does not rise the temperature, or that does not reduce the temperature, increases the temperature or reduces the temperature. Then the explanation of sublimation by the kinetic model, molecular model. When solids whose intermolecular force of attraction are weak, these type of solids only, they undergo sublimation. Okay, so whose intermolecular force of attraction are weak, are heated, their molecules acquire sufficient kinetic energy to overcome the force and they become free to move and change into gases. Directly into gases, their intermolecular separation becomes so large that they directly change into vapor. Next is we come to latent heat and specific heat, specific latent heat. Okay, so I think I'll discuss in my next video. Okay, and the question also I'll reply in my next video. Please go through this. If you have any doubt, please do write in the comment box and please answer in the comment box. I will also see to it and discuss in the next video. Okay, so please share with your friends. If you like the video, press the like button. And also if you have not subscribed yet, or you are a new viewer to my channel, please do subscribe to get the notification of my next video. Thank you.